We just come back from a big tour, man, of the USA, man, we have. Been over in the US of A, me and the lads, yeah, we have. Love and peace, then us, cocker, fire on, you know. Right on, goddamn. You know, we have been all over the place. It was smart, it was. We went over to America, we got sent there on a cultural exchange scheme. We'd sent the Boston Philharmonic over to Manchester, and Manchester Corporation thought, bugger this for a game of soldiers. We'll send Arden back over there, not send them rubbish bands over here. So I went over. And if you've never been to America, it's fantastic. Great. Everything over there is just as you've imagined it, just exactly as you've imagined it. Everything over there is bigger and stronger and longer and heavier and hairier and more frequent than over here, you know. The only trouble with it is the language. Don't ever imagine that you could go to America and understand what they were talking about. You couldn't do. No way. I mean, you may watch these cultural programs like Starsky and Hutch and Mindy and Mork and Dallas and that, and think that you can understand the language. They're overdubbed. The vocals on them are all overdubbed because you wouldn't understand real American. I was confused all the time I was there. Do you know what the hell they were on about? I was in this bloke's bathroom in Buffalo. If you don't know Buffalo, it's the sort of... it's the sort of Mexborough of America, you know, it's a sort of... or Bawtry, it's a bit like the Bawtry of the US of A, you know. And I was in this bathroom and it was one of them Uniflow taps. You know them one taps that sorts everything out? Now, to work them taps, you've got to be an Einstein to work them buggers out. Because it's either so fine coming out that it's like a thin mist and a fog and you're walking around banging into things and you've got toothbrushes snuck up your nose and the loofah's disappeared and you've got backache, you know. Or it's so strong coming out that it shredded all your skin off and you stood there with, like, all skin hanging off you, you know. Or it's so hot coming out that your wedding tackle is the colour of an Icelandic sunset. Or it's so cold coming out that everything's disappearing and you're praying it's going to come back again, you know. And me, I was jumping in and out of this shower trying to get it working. Like I was like a dog in a butcher's doorway, you know what I mean? And I'm jumping in and out. Eventually, I got picked off with this and I shouted downstairs, I shouted, Hank! Because they're all called Hank, Rocket Jr. or Slim, these blokes in America, right? And he shouted back and he said, what's the matter? I said, I can't get the tap to work. He said, the what? I said, the tap. The what? I said, the tap. What are you talking? I said, the bloody thing the water comes out of. He said, the faucet. I did force it. I ripped it off the wall. Sawed it out. Water everywhere. What a stupid name for a tap. A faucet. It doesn't even rhyme with tap, does it? Hey? And can you imagine asking somebody what they did for a living? What do you do for a living, you? Me? I'm a faucet dancer. You know? Stupid. Another word they have over there, an expression they have over there that's different to ours, a faggot. A faggot. Now, a faggot round our way, right? A faggot round our way, it's, you know, mincemeat sausage, you know, it's mincemeat, mince ball spicy that you can get from the butchers or the, you know, the chippy, you know, a faggot, you know? A faggot in America is not a sausage. A faggot in America is a bloke who likes other blokes, you know? I don't mean likes them, like you're coming for a game of arrows and a pint, mate. You know, I don't mean likes them like that. I mean likes them, you know, likes them like, you know, like, you know. You know, what my granddad used to call a brown hatter, you know. Now, not against, fair enough, each unto his own. If you haven't tried it, don't knock it and all this, you know. I've nothing against it, but it is very confusing when you suddenly find yourself with the wrong linguistic terms and suddenly find yourself, you know, confronted with the situation like I was. Went into a delicatessen, you know, I said, faggot and chips twice, please, our kid. You won't believe what I ended up with. You won't believe it. Two great big spade guys with blonde curly hair. But hey, you're kind of cute, old four eyes, you're kind of cute. How's about we go someplace and shoot some craps? I said, it's not very sporting, they don't move about very much, I said. Hey, man, He meant play dice. What a stupid expression to shoot craps, play dice. Another expression they have over there. Oh, you won't believe it. I can tell you don't believe it already. You won't believe it. They had an expression over there, to lose your cherry. To lose your cherry. To lose your cherry is not a Yugoslavian painter, right? To lose your cherry. Well, to lose your cherry in England, it just means you once had a cherry and now you haven't got a cherry. That's all it means, isn't it? You were... Now, to lose your cherry in America, it means to have physical knowledge of somebody for the first time, you know. You know, I don't mean bumping into somebody. I mean, carnival knowledge, you know. What the French call the leg over premiere, you know. It's true. Now, right, I'd no idea. Don't know one thing from another, at me. So I go in this, it's a sort of coffee bar, cake shop in the Greenwich Village there, you know, this trendy place. So I went in and I said, give us one of them rum barbers, pal. So he gives us a rum barber, like, and it's a big rum barber, huge lot of cream on top and a big cherry right on the top, like, you know. Oh, I said, that's a Monty, that's a Brahma, that'll do me, right. Walk straight out. The wind is howling down Bleecker Street, right. The wind's howling down. It goes, cherry, cream, gone. Offski lands on this dog's head, this cherry and the cream. Dog sees its reflection in a shop window, sees it suddenly got a bust on its head, can't work it out. Runs off down the road with this big bust on its head, go, oh, I can't go running. I threw the bottom end of the rum barber away, went back into the shop. I said, you better give me another cake, I've just lost my cherry in the road outside there. This fella's got a mouthful of hot coffee, he went, holy shit, what's happening round here? The goddamn Limeys are making out on the sidewalks already? I said, no, I just lost my cherry in the road, that's all. I said, a dog's run off with it down the street. Another expression they have there, to lay, the verb to lay. I lay, you lay, he lays, she lays, we lay, they lay, everybody lays, we all lay. The verb to lay, right? To lay. It doesn't mean what we mean by to lay. It doesn't mean that. No, no, no way. What, they don't have a word for our word, to lay, you know. They don't have that word at all over there. When they're tired in America, they say, gee, I'm tired, I think I'll have a not stand up. Because their verb to lay, it means rudies, you know. It means doing rudies, it means, you know, wham bam, thank you, ma'am, you know, rumpo rumpo. Dip your bread, that's what it means, you know. Well, I didn't know, I had no idea. I'm helping this woman in Buffalo there, and she's in the kitchen like she's stabbing the cabbage to put it in the pot, like, you know. And I said, while you're stabbing the cabbage, I'll go in there and lay the table for you, okay? Just before she fainted, she said, mind the knife draw, oh my God, mind the knife draw. What a stupid expression, stupid. I tell you what, when I get ideas, the brain's always going on its own. It works the brain, it's just going all the time, can't stop it. So when I get ideas, I write them down, right? I always write them down in pencil first. And if the idea works, I go over it in ink. If it doesn't work, I rub it out. So I always have loads and loads of pens and pencils and notepads and rubbers in my pocket. Now the trouble is, rubbers in America, they're not what we call rubbers. They're not what we call rubbers. What we call rubbers, they call erasers, which I thought you shaved with. It shows you how confusing. Confusing it can be. What they call rubbers, though, what we... Well, we don't talk about them very much. No, only in the dark and amongst friends, you know. It's they're contradictive things, you know. You know them funny chewing gum you can get out of the toilet, you know. You know, it tastes audible, but you make great bubbles with it, you know. You know, them things that make you like swimming with your wellies on, you know what I mean? I didn't know this. I'm walking through Central Park, New York. It's a lovely, sunny, Sunday's afternoon. It's beautiful, the sun's shining, we're walking along the usual New York sounds. You can hear people being mugged in the rhododendron bushes and hit with wet socks full of sand and things, you know. I'm walking along and I suddenly said, oh, I said, I've lost him. So I turned to this bloke and his bloke with his wife and his three kids. I said, hey, pal, I said, where can I get some rubbers around here? He went, shut up, shut up. I said, oh, I want some rubbers. He said, shut up, shut up. I I said, what's the matter? I just want some rubbers. He said, the kids will hear you. What's the matter with you? I said, so the kids will hear me. Haven't they got any? He said, what? I said, well, they give them you when you start school in England, you know. He said, what? I said, yeah, when you're 5 years old and you start school, they give you one and you write your name on it in case you lose it. I said, it's true. I said, it's gonna last you till you're 11 years old, that one. You go to secondary school. He said, goddamn cuckoos. He said, you Limey's a barmy. He said, over there in the drugstore, go on. So I went over to this drugstore, walked in, the old bloke stood behind. Well, I don't know a drugstore, do I? They sell everything there, from tin tacks to tractors. They sell the works in these huge drugstores. I went and I said, pal, you give us 4 dozen rubbers, please? I keep making terrible mistakes. Give us some big ones. I want them all big so I can write my name and address on them in case I lose them. Another expression they have over there. To knock somebody up. To knock somebody up, right? Now, around our way, to knock somebody up, it means knock, knock. Get up, Jimmy. You know, going fishing tomorrow, Fred. Give us a knock up 6:30. Well, you're on your way to work. Yeah, certainly. Your alarm clock broke down. Yeah, give us a knock up. Okay. Knock, knock. Get up. To knock somebody up. To knock somebody up in America, he means to get them pregnant. It's an expression used to get them in the club pudding. You know, to make someone in put them in family way. To knock somebody up. This bloke in Buffalo, he wouldn't believe it when I told him we are professional knocker-uppers in Lancashire. Oh, I said they can do 50 or 60 streets in the morning, no problem. So, yeah, I said they can stand on the pavement and reach the bedroom window. I said, it's true.